A logjam at shipyards nationwide is still impacting what you can buy and when you can buy it. Containers are stacked up at ports in Philly and Wilmington, but officials say they're working to get them moving. Sky Fox was over the Port of Philadelphia today. They tell us they've extended hours and bought additional equipment to help, but there's also the truck driver shortage and bottlenecks at other ports, making matters worse.
You may have noticed some bare shelves at grocery stores here the last few weeks. Maybe a few of your key items are missing off those shelves too. And we've noticed as well. In fact, as we talked about this story earlier as a team, we said that they've had trouble finding certain cereals, cream cheese, milk, just some random stuff. But it's hard to find, Seanette. And so you went grocery shopping tonight. Did you find what was on your list?
Well, it was actually you all's list, and since you didn't give me any money, I didn't actually shop. But Jason, I did find that you can get much of what you want, you just have to make some compromises.
It's everywhere.
Sabrina Black says grocery stores all over are being hit hard by chain supply issues. Deliveries not making it to stores means less on the shelves.
Like your toilet paper, your bathroom tissue, and that's hard to get.
I wanted to see what exactly is in stores, so I took a list of random items that my coworkers say they've been unable to find, and I went to three stores. This one in the Northeast, I checked off everything on the list. Milk, toilet paper, cream cheese, heavy cream, and cereal bars. But not every popular brand was there.
Well, I'm a brand name person.
So if they don't have your brand,
I'm not buying it.
We found Daryl Reed and his children, Heaven and Daryl Jr., at another grocery store in Bensalem.
It's been harder. They short on juice, snacks.
Again, we found everything on our list minus certain brands. And we also noticed signs like this about out of stock items and stating the store is working hard with suppliers to replenish quickly. And this sign limiting the number of household stuff you can buy.
I've been noticing it for about 2 weeks now.
It was a similar situation at the third store we walked through.
We drink lactate milk, and we have not been able to find that at all.
Satea Gordon says she's come up short too on her list recently.
It said limit 3 per family or limit 2 per family. There are no waters at all. It was like a couple cases of Deer Park, but that's it.
Worker shortages, backlogs on port containers, all contributing factors. Add to that, you're paying more for less.
I think prices are going up, definitely.
All right, so the moral of this story is you probably can get what you want, just be prepared to pay more. And if you're willing to change your brand, you probably can fulfill that list, Shane.
Scary.
Yeah, you just can't be too picky these days, I guess.
Yeah.
Thank you, Seanette.